That's true, sir. Like having a healthy mind and body means like enjoying a positive vibe. Okay. My next question is that, sir, like, what are the main functions of the skeletal muscle in day-to-day life?
Okay. Now, all the three types of muscles in the body, you know, the skeletal muscle, cardiac muscle, and smooth muscle, are all essential for all the activities in day-to-day life. We're coming to the skeletal muscles. The skeletal muscles are very much responsible for four of the important activities of the body. First one is mobility. All the movements of the body are brought by many activities of the skeletal muscles, the contraction and the relaxation of the skeletal muscles. The various movements occur in different joints, okay, like walking, running, cycling, dancing, swimming, and also the speaking and writing. For everything, the skeletal muscles are important, responsible for these movements. The next one is posture and stability. You know what is posture? That is keeping the body in upright position while sitting or standing or walking or doing any physical work. To maintain this posture, various movements occur in the body, which are called the postural movements. Now, all these postural movements which maintain the body in upright position against the gravitational force are brought out by only the skeletal muscles, which is responsible for posture. Right, now coming to the second point, which is stability. The stability of the joints, standing or moving or doing any physical work, it is provided by the skeletal muscles. Now the third function is breathing, respiration. A breathing, you know, it is necessary to supply of oxygen to tissues and the oxide from tissues. And this involves the activities of the respiratory muscles such as diaphragm, intercostal muscles, then the abdominis muscles, deep breathings. So all these muscles belong to the category of respiratory muscles. Now the last function,
heat production. Thank you, sir.
One more thing.
So actually, a skeletal system actually gave rise to a complex
movement. Sorry to interrupt you.
What are the immediate effects of exercise on skeletal muscle? Like sometimes we feel the pain like after doing exercise immediately. So like, why is it, sir?
Okay. What are the effects of immediate effects of exercise on skeletal muscle? There are three effects: the fatigue and the soreness. The fatigue, you know, it is the inability of the muscle to give response to the stimulus. Alright, so when you are doing any exercise for a longer period, at one stage, your muscle becomes tired. We don't call it tired, in physiology we call it fatigue. So the muscle fails to give response to the stimulus coming from the exercise. This, you know, it is because of exhaustion of the neurotransmitter acetylcholine, which is necessary for muscular contraction. Also, it is because of increased temperature in the muscle, the ionic imbalance in the muscle, and the impaired blood flow in the muscle, which all occur during the continuous exercise. Okay, that is about the fatigue. Now, another effect, immediate effect of exercise is muscle soreness. This muscle soreness is due to accumulation of the acid. The muscle will serve slight tearing or any micro damage, we call it micro trauma of the muscle fibers, which are caused by some simple contractions or excellent movements during exercise. There is some audio disturbance. There is some audio disturbance, you know.
So now it's fine, sir. Now it's fine, sir.
It's okay now, okay.
Yeah, sir. Now it's fine, sir. We can continue, sir. Thank you.
So, the immediate effects are fatigue and the soreness of the muscle. Right? Now we can go to the next one. Any comments on this? Now you and the participants can ask. Okay.
Thank you.
Dutta, kindly unmute yourself. Kindly unmute yourself.
Can you hear me?
I
have a network issue a bit, sir. So, okay, so like coming to the next question, like as people say, exercise is so important as you age. What is the significance of exercise in aging?
Significance of exercise on aging, meaning that, okay. Now, exercise has got significant benefits at all ages, right? Today, exercise makes a person feel younger, and it naturally slows down the aging processes in the chromosome itself, at chromosomal level itself. The exercise slows down the aging process, right? Now, the right kind of regular exercise can reduce risk of so many diseases. The major diseases which develop in old age are diabetes, obesity, hypertension, heart disease, Alzheimer's disease, osteoporosis, and risk of falling. See, the falling is a very common incidence in old age. So, if a person does regular exercise, he can avoid or at least postpone the development of these diseases. Right? And the recent study also found that physical activity was the number one contributor to longevity, adding extra years to your life, the physical and the mental health in good condition. Right? So, that is the effect of the significance of exercise on aging, right?
Yes, sir. So, guys, you know, exercise panana and just okay. So, like, which age group people can do cardiac, like cardio? Like, is there any separate age that people cannot do it, or like mainly old age people should not do it? So, like, is cardiac exercise genius, and what are its components?
So, yes, only human cardio exercise, not only cardio exercise, provided the person is fit enough to do the exercise, the person is fit enough to overcome the stress faced during exercise. So, it is very difficult to do. Okay. And at any age, the person can learn the exercise. He can begin the cardio exercise at any age, there is no age limit. Whether the person is able to walk, run, and do the day-to-day activities by himself or herself. Okay. So there is no age limit for doing any exercise. Okay. Of course, the intensity may be different. They cannot do the exercise with the same intensity as youngsters. Maybe at the beginning, once the person practices, they will become a young man as far as exercises are concerned. Okay.
Yes, thank you, sir. Like in the lockdown period, many are restricted to stay in their homes, and in order to maintain their body, they started working out in a closed room, or a few people just started working out in the terrace. So, which is more effective, like running on an open ground or working out in a gym? Yes, sir. Like in this lockdown, many people are restricted to stay in their homes. And so in order to maintain their body, they started working out in a like closed room, and few people started working out in an open terrace. So like which is like more effective, like running on an open ground or working out in the gym, sir?
Okay, now both methodologies, both the conditions, you work out in open ground. So, now the workout equivalent to treadmill is either fast walking or running. These are the equivalents of the preparatory treadmill, right? Now both have their own advantages and the disadvantages based on the individual training needs and the goals you want to achieve by the exercise, right? Now, running outdoors can improve stability by forcing it to negative, ever-changing terrain. And also you will have a mental alertness because you will be running on the ground, there will be so much strain, terrains. So you have to overcome that. So your mental alertness will improve if you run outdoors. And same that the treadmill forces you to speed up your performance levels. That means okay, lagging in outdoor workout. Right. Now, so few advantages of the treadmill workout and the running workout. The treadmill, there's no weather or temperature constraints. You can use treadmill in any condition, any temperature or any. If it's raining, you can go to the treadmill and do the workout. You can do it alone also, and at any hour, you can use it. And also, you have the option to control the pace of the speed. You can adjust the speed of your workout and also the interval. You can adjust the incline and also you can have a recovery by yourself. Right. But running outside has also some advantages. The most important advantage is the muscles and joints will be more conditioned by running on the open ground, because the treadmill running is only a passive, only the machine makes you run. You just close your eyes, hold your hand drive, and you can run. But running on the ground is not like that. You'll have to overcome all the obstacles which are coming on the way while running on the ground. So, not only your muscles and joints, even your mental activities are here in the brain. Consumed because of the varied terrain in the open ground, right? And also, the running in the open ground allows you to enjoy the nature and the breathe the fresh air, right? Which is missing in treadmill running. You will be working in a closed room with AC or with the bodies here, right? Another important thing, like running in outdoor ground, you burn more calories when you run outside. Okay. Because of the resistance, particularly from the wind or other factors which are persisting on the tail, or they are working hard in running outside rather than running on the treadmill. So definitely you burn more calories when you run outdoor. Okay. So these are the when you have time, when you have all facility, when you have time, you have proper atmosphere, you go outside. Otherwise, you can run on the treadmill also. It's nothing wrong with that. Okay, can you use both?
Yes, sir. My next question is, like, people go to gym, around 80% prefer like cool ventilated one, where you don't sweat much, and it's become a trendy to work out in ventilated area gym. So what are the disadvantages of working out in fully air conditioned gym? How to choose a workout space, sir?
Okay, first of all, I want to clarify one thing. You mentioned ventilation, then you mentioned the air conditioning gym also. The ventilation generally is provided by the outdoor gym, whether it is air conditioning or not the air conditioning. Okay, that is different issue. Now, your main concept is the disadvantages of air conditioning. Okay. I discuss both advantages as well as disadvantages also. But the air conditioning does not cause any effect, any significant effect on the quality of your workout. Okay. So the cool atmosphere in the gym will not hamper your workout that much, right? Working out in an AC gym also causes a lack of muscle ache and muscle tear. This is one thing. Disadvantages, which can be rectified or which will not be present in the non-AC room. Okay. What are the difficulties? Also, if you are working in an air-conditioned room, the it's difficult in warming up your body. Now, if you are doing any exercise, you know, you must warm up your body. And then, in that condition too, it takes a long time to warm up your body. So, by warming up your body, you definitely exert more energy. And then, warming up to a AC gym, you extract your energy, which makes you tired and exhaust easily. So, when you do the actual workout, you gain little strenuous. Okay. And the advantage of another thing, the body is cooled down very fast. So in between, if you have a pause on the treadmill, you want to take rest for about 30 seconds or 40 seconds. You put the treadmill in a pause, you stand, just walk around. At that time, the body goes down immediately. Again, the body will be warmed up. To catch up the pace, you have to really such a good or a fixer. Now both AC gym and non-AC gym have some advantages. We'll see first advantages of AC gym. AC gym provides comfortable atmosphere, no doubt about it. You can spend more time in a gym, watch your fitness goals with the temperature. It is comfortable for you in the AC gym. Right? And you know, even after workout, the body cools down very easily. And there are lesser muscle cramps. What are the advantages of non-AC gym? The important advantage is non-AC gym, you sweat a lot. And because of sweating, the various toxic substances are removed from the body. The sweating, that means sweating does not occur in my AC gym. No, only in non-AC gym, you sweat a lot. And that is an important advantage of running the treadmill in a non-AC gym or any workout in a non-AC gym, right? Another thing, it is easy to practice cardio in a non-AC gym rather than in a AC gym. Just for doing the cardio exercise, your body must always warm up. It's not the cool down. If the body is cool down while doing cardio exercise, then you have the healthy workout, right? And also, the soreness of the muscle is less in non-AC room rather than AC room. Okay. So these are the advantages and advantages and advantages of the AC room and the non-AC room. I think I made it clear.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. Sir, like, and due to this lockdown, work from home policies, people have become less active and foodies might be eating 24/7. So, fat burning has become very important. So, what exercises do you think one should do in order to burn fat?
Okay. We have plenty of options for being active during the fat burning. Of course, fat burning. Fat burning also, there are some key options which are good for reducing the fat content. Okay, now, what are the various blocks of exercises you can do at home when you are locked down? First is walking on the terrace, then jumping. If you have the proper terrace, you can go for a brisk crosswalk on the terrace. Then if you have small open space in your house, you can do jumping rope with the skipping. Then the steps climbing. Steps climbing means not a whole steps. So just one or two steps to go up, you can combine fast for about 5 minutes. It's very good exercise. Then if you have the facilities, you can do kickboxing. That is also better exercise at home. Then you can do the floor exercises, which are very important. And some other floor exercises will help you to burn fat also. What are the common floor exercises you can do at home? The push-ups, sit-ups, and other exercises like knees to chest, floor cobra, bridge exercise, crunches, And if you are afraid of doing lunges, you can do blinds, then the medicine ball exercise. Okay, these are the common core exercise which can be used not only to be active but also to lose some of your fat from your body. Then you can use strength training exercises by using dumbbells or blue bar. Right. Then resisting exercise, you can use some approach devices like Terabang. Okay. Then next one is the dancing. You know dancing? You can do dancing. It is a, you know, dancing is considered as one of the best cardio exercises. What are the best cardio exercises? The past walking was running, cycling, swimming, and dancing. So dancing is also best exercise provided you learn properly from somebody. You should not dance yourself, by then you will have some eccentric movements and you will damage your muscles. Right. So there are so many options in the pandemic period, in the lab, if you are locked down after them. Okay.
Yes,
sir. Okay, you can do it.
Yes, sir.
Somebody is, how long, one question is, how long you can do it? In catch up floor exercise. Now, floor exercise, you can do after 30 minutes daily. Okay.
Sir, the last question we spoke about fat burning. So, what is the physiology behind fat burning, sir?
Physiological process of fat burning. Okay. Now, the fat burning occurs in the body when fats are liberated from adipocytes due to circulation. To supply the energy required for the muscles. Right. Now, actually, fat burning will be any exercise. The burning of fat from the body starts only when any exercise is continued beyond 20 minutes. Now we come to this problem. Now let me tell you briefly about the adipocytes. What are adipocytes? Adipocytes are the fat storing cells. These fat storing cells are present under the skin throughout the body. These adipocytes are also present in ingredients surrounding vital organs for the sake of protection. Okay. So this, the fat that they are, the adipocytes which are present are surrounding the vital organs are called visceral adipocytes, right? Now, depending upon the energy required by the muscles, the adipocytes can release fat into the blood. And if the fat is more in the blood, we take so much of fat that they do, the fat will be created in the blood, in the adipocytes will take up the extra amount of fat from the blood and they start storing it among themselves. So the person, if you don't do any workout, you go on eating, then the adipocytes will go on accumulating the fat in the, make the person become obese. Right. So there is a balance between the food intake and the workout. Then only the adipocytes can release the fat whenever it is essential. Right. Now in the adipocyte, we make a study in biochemistry that the fat is stored in the adipocytes in the form of triglyceride. Now triglyceride is glycerol with three fatty acid base. Right. Now we come back to the question of working during the workout beyond 20 minutes. Disadvantage. When a person starts doing any work, particularly I'll give the example of cardio exercises, you'll understand better. If you are running or cycling, for the first few minutes, how the energy is supplied to the muscles. The muscles themselves have got the glycogen stored in them. So the glycogen stored in the muscle are utilized or metabolized for energy for the first few minutes, 2 or 3 minutes. Okay, now it is a anaerobic metabolism. No oxygen is required for this. So because of the anaerobic breakdown of glycogen, initially at the beginning of the workout, whenever lactic acid will be accumulated in the muscle. So this accumulation of lactic acid in the muscle will cause some burning sensation. So everyone, if they start working after 2 weeks, they have some burning sensation, particularly the beginners. And the same beginners may have even pain in the muscle because of the lactic acid accumulation. But it is only temporary. It is only after 2 to 3 weeks because the glycogen stored in the muscle will all the glycogen molecules stored in the muscle will be utilized within 2 to 3 weeks. Now after this, if you continue the workout, all the energy is liberated. Now the liver takes over. The glycogen stored in the liver is released into the blood. When the glycogen goes to the muscle, it is utilized for energy. So the liver glycogen is utilized for about 20 minutes. Okay. So if you continue the work by 20 hours, after 20 minutes or 25 minutes, even the glycogen stored in the liver will be exhausted. Now beyond that, what to do? How the energy is liberated to the muscle. Now, what happens if the person accumulates the workout beyond 20 minutes? Now the fat stored in the adipocyte, fat stored in the different parts of the body are converted into carbohydrates. They are released from the lipocytes. Fatty substances go to the liver. In the liver, the fatty substances are converted into carbohydrate. That is, you know, the neoglycogenesis. Now, the liver converts it into glycogen. That is, spent out the cell. So, if you want to actually burn fat in your body, you have to do any workout long continuous, at least for 5 to 10 minutes extra over 20 minutes. Of course, after exercise, when the glycogen from the liver is exhausted, the adipocytes can release some amount of fat because the blood level of the fat will be reduced. The adipocytes can release some amount of fat, but it will not be helpful to reduce the body fat. Okay. Is it clear now?
Yes, it is very clear.
Many people are asking questions. I'm not able to see the caption.
Sir, I'll ask it in the doubt session.
Okay, fine.
Yes, sir. Sir, my last question, like on an average, how long it takes for regeneration of skeletal muscles after injury?
Regeneration. So it depends upon the severity of the strength. If the strain is a common injury which occurs in the muscle, so if the strain is very mild, so it's any pulling up any muscle fibers or pulling up any tendon, it will pull too short time, it will be like a couple of days. Okay, but you say, when you go to gym, they ask you, you go cardio one day, and the next day you do the weight exercise. Why? When you do cardio, there are some minute trauma, we call it the micro trauma in any of the muscle fibers. It will take at least 38 hours for the regeneration of the muscle, for the muscle to put back into the action. That is why next day you should not go to the cardio, you must do the other exercises. Similarly, when you do any weight exercises, there is possibility that also again the neck trauma, neutral trauma, maybe because of the eccentric movements. You don't do the exercise properly, you may have eccentric movements that may cause the strain to the muscle. So, if it is very mild, the degeneration will be very sharp within a couple of days. Of course, this is only for beginners. If you have become, if you have practiced for longer time, then you can do cardio daily or you can do the muscle, the weight exercise thing. Right? Now, since the trauma is a little more severe, then it takes about 1 or 2 months for recovery. At that time, you must be complete. Rest, and also you must have necessary nutrients and proteins for healing purpose. Okay. And that if the strain is very severe, you have one week of pain, then you have to go and consult the doctor. He'll take at least 3 to 6 months will come back to normal functioning of the muscle. So totally, in an actual, you can say the regeneration of skeletal muscle after a very heavy exercise depends upon the severity of the strain. Okay. So, any question I wanted to ask? Anything else? Any other question? Only this much.
So only this much, like.
Before we go to the other open questions, I'd like to say a few things regarding the concept of the exercise. Okay. So before people start asking the questions, we wanted to tell you a few things about the components of the exercise. Okay. Many people will be eager to know this, particularly when you are doing any cardiac exercise. What are the various? Of course, the cardiac exercise is the way strain is one. The weight exercise is also strain, but if you can do it to the less weight and low grade weight, it will not become strenuous, whereas the cardiac exercise is definitely to strengthen, because it involves a lot of energy, it involves a lot of force, it involves effort and strength. You will be good for a fast walk, it involves lots of energy. So there are two categories of components of this exercise, called the general components and the physical components. What are they? No, we are not bothered about the general components. We are just tell you in a nutshell. There are four general components of the cardiac exercise. First is endurance. Endurance is the endurance, the respiratory endurance, vascular endurance, and the muscular endurance. Your heart must be able to cope up with the exercise. Your respiration, lungs must be able to supply constant oxygen. Then the blood vessels must cope up to supply the muscles. And the muscular endurance also is important. That is the endurance. The second component, general component, is muscular strength. You need muscular strength. Even for cardiac exercise, without muscular strength, you can't do the exercise when it becomes so painful. Then the flexibility of the joints. For any exercise, the flexibility is very important. So you must do some flexibility exercise before you start any cardiac exercise or any other types of exercise. And last one is the body composition. What is body composition? It is a ratio between the fat mass and the fat free mass. So we must have both the fat mass and also fat free mass. We do not have only fat free mass, because the fat also is essential for the body to protect the various organs and also to protect you from the cold environment. Plus, there are some other advantages also. So the body composition is very important component for any type of exercise. So it's particularly the cardiac exercise. Right. Now, coming to the physical components, this is important for the youngsters. What are the physical components of exercise? Now, the first, there are about 5 components. First one is warm up. Before you do any exercise, your body must be warmed up. So your muscles will be conditioned, the muscles will be ready to cope up with the stress you are going to face during the exercise. That is called the warming. We go for cardio, we go for a brisk walk, and you do some skipping, or slow running, like that. You do any other like weight exercise, you can do some flexion, extension, and some stretching. So warm-up is very important component. That is the first component of any exercise, particularly the cardio exercise. The next one is the intensity of work. Straight away, you cannot increase intensity to the maximum level. Okay. So you must increase the intensity of work slowly. So running or cycling, you go in a slow pace, that is slow speed, then go on increasing it. Straight away, you don't go in a higher pace. That is only for sprinters, a short time runners, 100 meters or 200 meters. Both intensity is can be increased, because it's the workout is only for a short period, maybe about 20 seconds or 30 seconds. But if you are doing any cardio workout, your intensity of work is very important. You must start with a low intensity, gradually increase intensity. and which form duration. Now duration, it depends upon the body composition, depends upon the strength of your muscle, depends upon the stamina you have in your body. So the beginners don't run for 1 hour, don't run for 6 hours, 6 kilometers, 8 kilometers straight away, you should not do them. You'll be more than a short time. Your heart load will increase and you will develop the cardiorespiratory problems. So the duration is gradually increase the duration for 1 hour. Now, next fourth one is cool down. No matter what comes, your body must be completely cool down. So today, don't go to the bathroom and shower yourself after any exercise, particularly the body exercise, because you have lots of sweat, the body with the temperature will be more, step away the shower with higher than the thermal relief system, the hypothalamus will be much affected, and you will have shivering, and then arthritis will be very severe. So, cool down is very important after any exercise, particularly the body exercise. And afterwards, the stretching. Stretching exercises are really important after any exercise, clearly after any. There are some important post-run stretches like the squat or thigh stretch in standing, leg raise in lying position, knee bending in lying, leg stretch in standing, off stretch, spine twist. So some of these stretches you must do, because if there is any spasm, you may not feel it, or if there is any mild strain because of the eccentric movements, you may not feel it immediately, but if you do the stretch exercise, you can overcome those mild strains. So these are the components of, physical components of exercise. Everyone must keep in mind when you do any exercise. Okay, the warm-up. First one is warm-up. Second one, intensity of work. Third one, duration of work. Fourth one, cool down. And fifth one, stretching exercise. Okay.
Thank you, sir. Like now, coming to the doubt sessions, if anyone has doubts, you guys can write down in the chat box. So there is a doubt from a person. The question is, sir, how can we reduce injuries to ligaments while exercising?
Again, the ligament injury occurs because of lumbar mobility. We call it the eccentric movements. Okay. If you are doing any cardio exercise, then fat burning exercise, you start proper footwear. That is very important. If you don't have proper footwear, particularly you will injure your ligaments. Okay. And also, while running on the ground, you must be very careful. Doing a slight depression on the ground will make you strain your ligaments. So, when you run or when you do fast walking in the open ground or on the road, you must be looking at the ground, not on off the ground. Okay, so you must be very careful so that you can avoid the ligament. The ligament tear is very severe than the muscle. Muscle tearing at the muscle fibers, you know, tearing at the muscle fibers will be alright, will be regenerated in 2 weeks or 3 weeks or months soon. But ligament tear is, takes a long time for the tear. So you will be very careful, so wear proper dress, wear proper footwear, and workout when you do any cardio exercise or fat burning exercise. If you do it on the ground, if you do it on the treadmill, it's okay, you can safely run. But if you do it on open ground, it's always cautious about the ground level. Okay, even a small stone will make you skip. Okay, and the stone you wear, the ligaments.
And
another question is it necessary to do cardio and cycling or running before exercise? And if it is, why so? Not the only exercises for cardio. We have swimming, dancing, running and cycling are the best ones because continuously burn energy. You continuously exert energy. Whereas in swimming, after 1 lap or after 2 laps, you take some rest. it's merely in dancing. After dancing for about few minutes, you take rest. Whereas running and cycling, you can continuously breathe. Now, for beginners, it may be strenuous, but once they practice, it is a best exercise for running. To another important thing, simply running for 6 kilometers daily will not make you reduce your weight or fat. Simultaneously, you must have control through your food intake. That is very important. Because after workout, you will be more hungry. Because after the workout, for the 3 to 2 hours, for at least 1 hour, 1 or 2 hours, the fatty level and the blood will be less. So the blood supply to hypothalamus will have less fat, less fat blood rates. So the hypothalamus will instigate you to take more and more food. So you must have control over your food intake. Otherwise, you become obese. So simply running or simply run cycling will not help you in any way to reduce the fat or your food. Simultaneously, you must have some control. Of course, you will not be restrict your diet completely. So take a regular food. Start taking some extra food or extra snacks. So you take everything in small quantities. Okay.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. And my next question is, like, what are the side effects of vigorous dieting and excessive calorie deficit diet?
If you are very severely follow the diet restrictions along with workout, the first one is you become very lightly, because one side, you are wasting energy, your calories are wasted, calories are replaced. Otherwise, no input of calories, you don't eat properly, no input of calories. So there is no balance between the calories input and the calorie output. So you become very weak, you become lethargic, at one stage, you become even unable to do work. And also, mentally, you will be depressed. So always, you should not have both simultaneously, the severe dieting along with the strenuous exercise. So severe dieting, even both exercise is dangerous. Want to both dieting, slowly reduce that quantity of the food intake. Okay. And similarly, exercise also, I told you, the intensity of exercise. Don't start doing strenuous, with a high intensity of the thing. Slowly you can dial up. Okay. For a period of years, period of months, you start running for 3 kilometers, keep it for 1 month, 2 months, and slowly increase the speed and increase the length, time and duration. At one stage, after a few years, you'll be able to run more than 6 kilometers without any pain or discomfort. So the intensity and the duration of this is very important to maintain the stamina of the body, right?
Yes, sir. So my last question, we kept a survey of hundreds of people who wanted me to ask this question. Like, what is your motive for writing this book, and how come you came across an idea of making the subject easier so easy?
First part I can understand. What is the second part of the question? First part, what is the motivation?
How come you came across this idea of making the subject physiologically?
Right. First question. If the answer is little wrong, maybe people will be listening to me. Of course, it will not be boring. Now, when we started our career, myself and my wife, when we started taking classes, we used to have our own class notes. Yeah. So for every topic, we used to prepare our own notes. So before going to the class, we prepare. So year after year, we prepare, we updated those notes. So during that time, we observed two things. Number one, at that time, there were no Indian books. All the books are by foreign authors only. So at that time, I am talking about, say, 30, 35 years back, right? There were only foreign books like Kaiden, Ganon, Austin Tyler, Samson Bites, right? And there were no Indian all your books, not to all the books are very good, no doubt about it. Title is a very good book. Ganani, it is a review. Ganani is not a textbook, but it is a review book, because every year whatever new findings are coming in theology, you will see in Ganani first. So Ganani is not a textbook for undergraduates, but it is a review. You will have new concepts of theology, you know. And also the another two more books, Dustin Taylor and Samson Life. But the problem is, problem was, something which is given in one book will be missing in another book. For example, if Titan gives anything, the same fact will be missing in other books. Suppose Samson Life gives some explanation in some topic, that will be missing in non-Titan. So students have to suffer, they have to prefer at least 3-4 books in those days. There was not a single book to do, all the basic concepts of theology was not available at that time. Okay. That made us to think, why can't we make a book with all the explanations of basic concepts of theology and include together. That was one of our reputation factors. Right. Now another thing, during our career, worked in different colleges, worked in many states, worked in Karnataka and worked in Chennai Ramachandra. So, in around this period, we observed one thing among the students. In the foreign books, the city students were able to follow the language. But our rural students, not only in Tamil Nadu, everywhere throughout India, because we used to go to conferences to different states, and we used to hear from the faculty members or colleagues in different states that the rural students found it very difficult to understand the language allowed in the foreign books. And that made us able to write a simple book, particularly for the rural students who can understand the basic concepts of theology. And simultaneously what happened when we both were working in Ramachandra, many of our friends, including with some of the students, they started motivating us. Oh, we can't believe the students are liking, like students like your notes, classmates, we can't do to write a book. And there was an anatomy professor called Dr. Nanadin. He himself has written an anatomy book, Dr. Nanadin. I don't know how many of you have seen that. He motivated us very much. He used to call me every day, something what you have decided, start writing the book, start writing the book. Then we started writing the book. And also what happened, in the more thing, it is really personal, but it's still I would like to share with you. Some of the notes, class notes, started spreading to other colleges and the other places. Then everybody warned us, the notes has crossed our palate, gone to many places. So before somebody collect and publish it, we publish it before that. So that made us to convert all our notes into the book format. And just because we wanted to make a simple book with explanations of all simple basic concepts of theory, the book has become easy to read by everyone. Clear?
Yes.
And also, when they took about 6 or 7 months for converting our class notes into the manuscript for a book. We used to write, both of us, myself and me, we had a different type of notes for each topic. We merged it together for each topic. When we typed, at that time the computer was not yet there. The phone computers that just started coming in the market, there was no Google, there were no other online browsing services. So we had to see the books only. We merged the book and converted it. It took us about 6 to 7 months. Then after merging and after typing, we used to sit together and read ourselves. We are students and we just find out whether it is able. Students can understand each sentence. And it took about 3 months for us to change it in the students' point of view. And finally, we become grammatical mistake. So even so, there are grammatical errors. At that time, no online dictionary, no online compensation for US child Oxford dictionary and the medical dictionary and the useful chain and mother if that's very good in grammar that way. So we corrected all the grammatical mistakes and then we send it for application. That is the story of coming out of this book.
Okay.
Yes, sir, that was actually amazing. And there have been comments like without your book, like first year I clear panna mudiyadun kuda. So that's nice actually.
Illa padichadana panna mudiyadhu endha book adhaan padichadana pass panna mudiyum nee simple ah irundha
adhu
enna
book konja easy ah irukudhu adhu nalla pass aayittom. Okay sir, so one more question, like nariya pe kittirundha, what is yoga and meditation? Like how do these two things differ from each other? And people misunderstand between these two words, like mind and the...
Yoga is different, meditation is different. Okay. Yoga also is good. The various yoga exercises, the yoga asanas are really good exercises. It makes you really fit. It gives you the endurance. Of course, fat burning and all you use go for the exercise. But yoga asanas are very good for particularly the flexibility of the joints in your body, plus keeping the fitness of the muscles, the fitness of the brain. So meditation is a different type. It doesn't involve any exercise. The calmness of the brain, the silent atmosphere, and that is necessary for a maintenance of a healthy mind. We ask at the beginning, for healthy mind, the meditation is a very important factor. If you meditate, you can get rid of the stressful urges of your brain, so that quickly you become calm. So yoga and the meditation are differently. That one thing, whether it is yoga, it is meditation, don't do it, you don't learn yourself, you learn from somebody who knows it, particularly yoga. You don't do the others, the yoga asanas properly, then you will have eccentric movements I told earlier, and then you will damage yourself. Okay, but both are good. Sports science section, you will find lots of books. Even some of the Indian authors have written. Okay. And also, first one, the Oscar physical therapy students. There are many books regarding exercises. Okay. So, you can refer the sports science books as well as the physiotherapy books, particularly for various exercises to maintain the body fitness and also the exercises after injury, particularly you must refer the physiotherapy books.
Okay sir, thank you so much. So words are enough to thank you. You have been a guiding light as a mentor, a teacher and a leader for all of us. And keep blessing us, guiding us, because we want to carry forward this beautiful journey of physiology. And thank you so much for enlightening us, and thank you so much sir, it's a pleasure.
The pleasure is mine. It's a nice to come to talk to the youngsters. Yeah. I cleared many of your doubts. Okay. So have a nice time.
Thank you.
Yeah. Okay. Thank you. Thank you for the organizers, Saravanan, Rehearsal, Dakshani.
Okay. Thank you, sir. Thank you so much for joining with us, sir. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Bye.
Bye, sir.
Bye.
Bye.
Bye. Bye.